Hello, welcome. In this video, we will discuss the analysis of the news on it. That is the All India Radio News of 14th and February and 15th February. That is today. Let's start our discussion. The first article regarding today, the FASTag will end its last date. That's why we will discuss all about the FASTag. What is all about the FASTag? It is a reloadable tag, allows automatic deduction of the toll without having to stop for carrying out the cash transaction. This FASTag uses radio frequency identification, that is the RFID technology, and it is fixed on the windscreen of the vehicle once it will be active. This is all about the introduction of the FASTag. And coming to the other important things, coming to the RFID, radio frequency identification, it is the use of the radio waves to read and capture the information stored on a tag attached to an object. That is, ఒక ఆబ్జెక్ట్కి లేదా ఒక ట్యాగ్కి అటాచ్ ఒక ఆబ్జెక్ట్కి అటాచ్ చేసిన ఒక ట్యాగ్కు ఉన్న ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ని క్యాప్చర్ చేసి రీడ్ చేయడము రేడియో వేవ్స్ ద్వారా జరిపేదాన్ని రేడియో ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ ఐడెంటిఫికేషన్ అనేసి అంటామన్నమాట. ఏ ట్యాగ్ కెన్ బి రీడ్ ఫ్రమ్ అప్ టు సెవెరల్ ఫీట్ అవే అండ్ డస్ నాట్ నీడ్ టు బి విత్ ఇన్ డైరెక్ట్ లైన్ ఆఫ్ ద సైట్ ఆఫ్ ద రీడర్ టు బి ట్రాక్డ్. ఇలా రేడియో వేవ్స్ ద్వారా రీడ్ చేసి క్యాప్చర్ చేయడానికి విత్ ఇన్ విన్ కాంటాక్ట్లో డైరెక్ట్ లైన్ ఆఫ్ సైట్లో ఉండని అవసరం లేదు. సెవెరల్ ఫీట్ నుంచి కూడా రేడియో వేవ్స్ యూజ్ చేసి ఇది రీడ్ చేస్తుంది అనమాట. నెక్స్ట్ వచ్చేస్తే, ద ట్యాగ్ ఈస్ వ్యాలిడ్ ఓన్లీ ఫర్ 5 ఇయర్స్ అండ్ కమ్స్ ఇన్ డిఫరెంట్ 7 డిఫరెంట్ కలర్స్. ద ఫాస్ట్ ట్యాగ్ విల్ కమ్ ఇన్ 7 డిఫరెంట్ కలర్స్, వైలెట్, ఆరెంజ్, ఎల్లో, గ్రీన్, పింక్, బ్లూ, బ్లాక్. ఈచ్ కలర్ ఇండికేట్స్ ద టైప్ ఆఫ్ వెహికల్ which is carrying the particular type of category of goods or a particular type of vehicle. And the scheme was rolled out in 2016. Government made it mandatory from December 1, 2017 for all new cars and trucks to be fitted with a FASTag before they were sold. To encourage the use of FASTags, National Highways Authority of India, that is NHAI, refunds 5% of the total monthly transaction. Among the total monthly transaction, it refunds 5% as a sort of the encouragement program. And Indian Highways Management Company Limited, IHMCL, a company incorporated by the NHIA and National Payment Corporation of India, are implementing this program. Which two organizations are implementing the FASTag? Or means, Indian Highway Management Company Limited and the National Payments Corporation of India, which is the total digital payments card manager of India, that is the National Payment Corporation of India. And FASTag is presently operational both at the national and the state highways. What are the benefits by using the FASTag? Ease of the payment and non-stop movement of the vehicle, leading to the lower fuel cost. And some of the other benefits include environmental benefit, air pollution will be reduced due to the reduced use of the paper for the bills and other things. And social benefit will be reduced toll payment hassles, analytics of the better highway management. And economic benefit will be reduced effort in management of the toll plaza and reduced effort in monitoring centrally, all these things. And coming to the air analysis, coming to the first article regarding the Pahela Phagun is a spring festival which is celebrated in the Bangladesh, whereas the spring festival is celebrated as New Year in the China. Coming to the Bangladesh, the name of the spring festival is the Pahela Phagun. This Pahela Phagun will be celebrated in the Bangladesh every year with the beginning of the spring. And the programs were held at Sukhravardi Udayan and Nandan Manch of the Shilpa Kala Academy of the Dhaka. Different things. What you have to remember here is the Pahala Phagun was a spring festival which is celebrated in the Bangladesh. That's all. Nothing else important. And coming to the next article, Mexico receives shipment of 870,000 doses of the COVID-19 vaccine from India, from the AstraZeneca's COVID-19 vaccine, which is made in India. And the Mexico and Argentina agreed to be supplied with the AstraZeneca vaccine in eventual distribution of the 250 million doses in the Latin America, with the financial support from the foundation of the Mexican billionaire Carlos Slim. This is not important. And what you have to remember is, among the vaccine diplomacy, the country Mexico also covers. From the Latin American countries, Mexico and Argentina, the both countries are covered under the vaccine diplomacy of India. And coming to the other things, next article, regarding the shifting of the Rohingyas to the Bashanchar Island, another 2,000 Rohingyas refugees have been sent to the newly developed Bashanchar Island, who were located in the Bangladesh. What is this Rohingya refugees? These Rohingya refugees are originally from the Rakhine province of the Myanmar, and these refugees come back to the Bangladesh from the Myanmar due to the violence in the military violences in the Rakhine province in 2017. They came as refugees to the Bangladesh and settled in the Bangladesh, but Bangladesh government has been classified them as the illegal migrants, and thus all the Rohingyas will be sent to the Bashanchar Island. Coming to the Bashanchar Island, Bashanchar is a uninhabited island which is formed in the Bay of Bengal about 20 years back. And the environmental says that Bashanchar falls in an economically fragile area, which is not that much safe for the floods, erosion and cyclones have been frequently affected this area. But the government says that it has taken adequate safety arrangements in terms of embankments, cyclone shelters, all these things. It has been managed, and nothing important. And coming to the next article, government announces the launch, the government announces Jal Jeevan Mission Urban and Jal Jeevan Mission Rural in line with the budget of the Union Budget 2021. With an outlay of 2,87,000 crore rupees has been implemented over the 5 years, it said. By supplying clean drinking water, it will cover the Sustainable Development Goals number 6, health and sanitation, clean environment and the drinking water. And coming to the next article, these are all about the 14th and 15th, these are all about the, on which day, 15th international articles regarding the Iran news analysis. And coming to the 14th, sniffer dogs participate in the Indian Navy simulated bomb threat exercise. Indian Navy had carried out maiden exercise of slithering down from a helicopter with explosive sniffing dogs. It is which you have to remember, not for the UPSC perspective, but for other exams. Two explosive sniffing dogs named Minky and Mukti has been trained off to sniff out explosives rather than inducting the harming personnel. It is using the dogs for the identification of the threatening things. And coming to the next article, PM Less Foundation, Stone of the Maharaj Suhaldev Memorial Development Work of the Chittaura Lake tomorrow. Maharaja Suhaldev's devotion service to the country is a source of inspiration to all. Just read about some facts about the Maharaja Suhaldev devotion. That's enough. And coming to the next article, Union Textile Ministry, Smriti Irani rolls out commercial jute seed distribution scheme. Commercial jute seed distribution scheme. The Jute Corporation of India last year signed an MOU with the National Seeds Corporation for commercial distribution of nearly 1,000 metric tons of the certified jute seeds for the year of 2021 to 2022. Highlighting the work done by the center to help the jute farmers in the country, Smriti Irani said that increased minimum support price for jute from nearly 76% from in the last 6 years has been seen. And she said MSP for jute stands for 4,225 rupees for the financial year of 2020 and 21 compared to the 2,400 in the 2014 to 15. Comparing with these numbers, an increasing of 76% of the minimum support price by the government. On par with this, Agriculture Ministry and Textile Ministry are working together in a cooperative way in the jute growing for the jute growing farmers. All these things have been discussed here. And coming to the next article, government dismisses media report of Devendra Kula Vellalar community will be delisted from the scheduled caste soon. It was the statement was dismissed by the government media. This media report dismissed by the government. The union government has dismissed a media report of the saying that Devendra Kula Vellalar community, which has been recently categorized 7 SC caste into this new name. A statement has been circulating in the media saying that this category has been delisted from the SC community. The Social Justice and Empowerment Ministry termed that report is misleading and saying that it does not reflect the actual position. And the government has been opposing the move. Therefore, the statement that they will be delisted from the SCs and will be made OBCs is completely an incorrect statement. They will be only in the SC list of the Tamil Nadu, which is already introduced in the Lok Sabha as the bill. And this all about the thing. And coming to the other things, PM Modi hands over the Chadar to offer the Ajmer Safari Dargah 809 years of the Kajwa Mohanuddin Chisti. In this perspective, you have to remember who is the Kajwa Mohanuddin Chisti and what is his historical significance. This you have to once read. And coming to the next article, governmental increases budget of Department of Science and Technology and Ministry of Earth Sciences by 30% in the union budget compared to the revised estimate of 2020-21, a increase of 30% of the compared to the last year budget allocation of the Science and Technology and Earth Ministry has been increased this outlay. This year, an allocation of 16,694 crore has been given to the two ministries. Thus, India's remarkable accelerated growth in the fields of the science and technology, said the science and technology ministry and the health ministry. Over 50,000 crores have been allocated for the National Research Foundation for the different research projects of the India, and a deep ocean mission will be launched with a budget outlay of 4,000 crores for better synergies among research and development institutions. Umbrella structures will be set up in 9 cities, said the Harshavardhan. And the minister informed that National Research Foundation will be an independent society, and it will build on existing national strengths and in research and innovation, and it will fill the gaps current research and education ecosystem augment India's research and innovation achievement. This is all about the things. And coming to the next article, PM Narendra Modi liberalizing policies for acquisition and production of the geospatial data, and will provide huge impetus to the digital India. Modi said that liberalizing policies for the acquisition and production of the geospatial data will be provided, which will give huge impetus to the Digital India program. In a tweet, he released that new geospatial guidelines today has been issued on par with the development of the new maps, which will be developed indigenously by the Indian company, which will be the replacing the Google Maps under the Atmanirbhar Bharat. And the Prime Minister also added, reforms will unlock tremendous opportunity for the country's startups and private sectors and public sector and research institutions to drive the innovations and build scalable solutions for the country. And he also said that this will also generate employment and accelerate economic growth in the country. And coming to the next article, government increases budgetary allocation to create robust educational infrastructure through the new National Education Policy of 2020. Get into the article, the government emphasizing to create a robust educational infrastructure across the country through National Education Policy and increased budgetary allocation to the education sector in the 2021. The fund allocation to several educational schemes have been increased substantially in order to boost the education sector. Speaking to the Air News, Professor Amendranath Behera, NCRT, the name is not important. He said that National Education Policy and Budget 2021 have given the utmost importance to the training of the teachers, which will play an instrumental role in improving the quality of education and regarding the future of the students. And the government also stressed on need to create a national digital infrastructure in the education sector in order to provide initiatives through the digital divide, such as initiatives such as PM E-Vidya, Deeksha and Swayam Prabha. These are some of the platforms provided by the government of India in order to encourage the education in the digital mode. These three platforms you have to remember. It will help your mains answer writing content. That is the PM E-Vidya, Deeksha and Swayam Prabha platforms. And coming to the Mohinuddin Chishti, take a look at Chishti Mohinuddin or Mohinuddin Chishti or Khwaja Garib Nawaz, who is a Muslim of the Indian subcontinent, a Persian preacher, ascetic and religious scholar, philosopher and mystic from the Sistan, who eventually end up setting in the Indian subcontinent in the early 13th century. He promulgated famous Chishtiya order of the Sunni mysticism. What is he famous for? He promulgated the Chishtiya order of the Sunni mysticism in the Indian subcontinent, and in particularly Tariqa. He which become the dominant Muslim spiritual group in the medieval India. Most beloved and venerated Indian Sunni saints were from the Chishti in their affiliation, including the Nizamuddin Awliya and Amir Khusro, all these things from the Chishti lineage. And coming to the other important thing, he is very famous among the Chishti Sufis. He arrived Delhi during the reign of the Sultan Iltutmish. And he moved from Delhi to the Ajmer shortly, and at which he became increasingly influenced by the writings of famous Sunni Hanbali scholar and mystic Abdullah Ansari, whose work influenced his early Islamic saints and have played a role in the shaping of the Moinuddin's worldview. And other important things are he was died in 15th March 1236 CE in the Ajmer of the Delhi Sultanate, and born in 1st February 1143 in the Sistan, that is the in the Ghaznavid Empire of the Afghanistan, and resting place is the Ajmer, and belong to the Sunni community. And he belongs to the Chishti Tarika, and the Queen is the Maturidi, and the jurisprudent is the Hanafi. These are not that's important. You have nothing to remember from this. You have to remember who is the Moinuddin Chishti and where he belongs. And other thing is, when he come to the Delhi, whose reign in that time has been in the Delhi Sultanate. These things are enough for you. This is all about today's analysis.